Hey guys, it is Carl Brown for guitarlessons365.com. Today we'll learn how to play Strawberry Fields Forever by the Beatles, of course. Now this is obviously a guitar arrangement, so there are some actual guitar parts to the song that I won't be covering because they're mostly used for kind of layering. I'm going to stick with an actual arrangement to where you can just play it with one like acoustic guitar, so it requires you to kind of really play the chords instead of these little layers and stuff. I will show you some cool stuff like the little sitar things. So we'll do some cool stuff like that as well. All right, so I've arranged this beginning little, I guess, a mellotron thing here. In order to play this, the actual song is not in a particular proper pitch because they're combining two different versions of the song, so it's actually kind of halfway between A and B flat. It's closer to B flat, so that's why I have a capo here at the first fret. So now you can learn the song like I'm going to show you here, and if you want, take the capo off and just move everything down a fret, and you'll be playing an A. It'll still sound great that way too, and you don't have to deal with a capo. But I'm trying to make it so if you were going to play along with the recording, this would be kind of the closest way to do it. All right, but it still won't sound completely right unless you tune to that kind of halfway in between tuning. So let's start here with this intro. All right, now that is also the verse of the song, so we're gonna get a lot of mileage out of this. We're gonna start here with the low. I'm just gonna call everything like this is just zero fret. So everything above it, so I'm gonna say this is seventh fret here. It's actually eighth fret on the guitar, but it's seven frets above the capo. So the low E open, all right? And then we have the seventh fret above the capo. It's just a standard major chord. So that's seventh fret above the capo here, and then barring the ninth fret above the capo, or the 10th fret on the guitar, across the D, G, and the B strings. So we have this. So I strum it first with the low string in it, and then I just let that ring, and then just strum the four middle strings again without hitting the low string. Just let that ring. So you strum it twice, and then we'll move it to the F major 7. So you don't have to do the bar anymore. Now that's just here. We basically move the note on the G string back one fret. And now, in order to do that, now you need to use your pinky there. That's nine frets above the capo, eight frets above the capo here on the G string, and then nine frets above the capo on the D. So now strum that one twice. And now just do a bar here with your index finger and lift up your second finger to make it a dominant seven chord. So you get there, and then we're gonna do this little. All right, so we're gonna be here at nine frets above the capo on the B string, or the 10th fret on the guitar. I know it's kind of tempting when you're this far up, it's almost tempting just to call it the actual frets, but I want to keep it consistent here. So nine frets above the capo, and then seven frets above the capo here. Take that, play those two strings together. I like to use, you can just use a pick across those strings. I like to pick on the B string and middle finger on the high E. And then just move that down two frets. Now move it down two more frets, but when you get down there, instead of playing this here, three frets in front of above the capo, play it four frets above the capo with your second finger. Same note on the B string though. All right, then move up here, six frets above the capo. So that's just picking across to G minor. So we're gonna have that six frets above the capo there. Remember, it's the seventh fret really, but and then across here, so it's seventh fret above the capo on the B string, and a fifth fret above the capo on the high E. Pick across that, and then you're going to come back one fret and play like a D major chord shape. In this case, it's an F, but it's the same as a D major that you probably already know. And then we're gonna jump down here and just play a D major chord and then an A chord. So all together. All right, now as soon as we hit that A, we're gonna start into the chorus, which is the first vocals that comes in a song. They hit that A again, but this time, kind of the low E string in the bass. So whenever they're leading into the chorus, you're gonna have that A major chord. Remember, it's an A major compared to where the capo is at. With the low E open. And then we go into the... Now this is an E minor 7 chord, obviously an F minor 7 chord where we're at, but I'm comparing it to the capo. So that all it requires you to do is put the second fret above the capo here on the A string. And the rest of the string's open. Then we're gonna go up here, just two frets above the capo, a bar chord, that's gonna be a dominant 7 chord, and then fourth fret above the capo here on the A string, and third fret above the capo on the G string. Back to the D major shape, and back to that dominant 7 chord. Then back to the D again. Hit it a couple times and then the A. So all together, the chorus sounds like this. Now the strumming pattern, if you're into that kind of thing, knowing exact strumming patterns that I'm doing, is just down, 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 up, down, 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 up. That third downstroke every time, kind of accenting a little bit. And then the end, just a couple hits on each one. Two hits and then one hit on the last one. Then we go back into the verse again, and it's a lot of the same thing as the intro. The whole beginning is the same. Now here we have more to it, so they extend it here. So that basically what the intro is, the first half of the verse. And then from there, we're gonna do this. Alright, so after that little intro, when we get down to the D from the intro, here's where we start doing the second half of the verse. This is going to be a G, well, we'll compare it to the capo, an F sharp minor chord. So two frets above the capo, full bar, and then four frets above the capo on the A and the D string. So you play this chord, all six strings. And then what I want you to do is just move your index finger down to where it's just barring like the top three. And then still strum the all six strings. So now that note on the capo there is the bass note. So it's the same chord, but the note on the low E string went down two frets. From there, we're gonna go to the D major chord and the E chord. From there, we're gonna go to an A. Now, I want you to play this A major like this, just barring across the, instead of playing it like with these three fingers or however you play your A, just bar across two frets up above the capo, and then the open A. So those four middle strings, hit that, and then what I want you to do is reach over and grab, this is kind of a stretch, the four frets above the capo here, along with that A. So we have this. And then it goes to that minor chord again with its alteration as well. So there's a little bass line going. we're trying to get that in around the chords. So we're going. Now you can just pick the chord, then that bass note, chord, bass note if you want. Then after that, we'll go back to the D, back to the E, and then back to the D. And there's a little bass line leading us to the A. So from that D, that last at the very end of this verse, number two, the 4-2 on the above the capo, on the A string, into the A chord. So all together for that second verse, coming out of, after we get this intro part, here's the new stuff. The last two chords, bass line. Then we hit this A again with the low E in, because that sets us up for the chorus again. Chorus is the same as the first one, except when you get to the first dominant chord, they don't hit a lot of the low G. It's just hanging on this D. The cellos are what you really hear, is that D there. So you can kind of just make it a five string chord if you want. It's kind of like this. When you play the next time, the full chord. It's just, they're just doing an inversion there. So they're gonna be doing a second inversion G7 chord. All right, so, but everything else is the same. Now, leaving that second chorus, we have the first little, it's like an Indian harp that he's using. I don't think it's a full sitar. It looks like this, it sounds like this. Now the way to kind of recreate that kind of stuff is let the notes bleed together as much as possible, just ring in together. So I'm going to start here, and I'm going to actually call out the frets here. The guitar might be a little bit easier up here. So that is the actual 11th fret on the guitar, not above the capo, actual 11th fret, and then down to 10th. Now let that note ring as you go and play the 11th fret on the beat, and then the 13th fret on the G string. So I'm letting them ring. And then the next four notes, I'm going to be able to, they're down here, but I'm going to hit the high E string open and then jump down here. And now I'll actually call out the notes, how far they are above the capo. It's three frets above the capo on the B string, then two, and then the second fret above the capo on the G string. So let those all ring as much as you can. So let that open string give you a chance to shift down there. All right, so that's a cool little lick that you can do. They do it after the next chorus as well. Now, the third verse has a little bit of a little cello line in it. So everything stays the same pretty much in verse three. Just, you can maybe strum those sometimes. Same as the previous verse. And then here, when you get to this D, four hits, then four hits on the E, then you'll hear this little lick in there. Now that is just gonna be, now you can just do the standard chords we did before. If you don't wanna do that lick, and if you have a second guitar player that can maybe play the lick, and then you play just the standard chords that just like we did in the second verse. But here's the lick. So that's open D, then four frets above the capo on the D, then up two frets above the capo on the G, back to the four frets above the capo on the D. So that's the actual lick. Then move everything up one string and do the exact same lick. And then into that A chord with the E in the bass. And then that takes us to the next chorus, which is the same as the previous. where they kind of hang out on that second version chord. When they get to that chord the first time. And then. And that same little lick there. Now for verse number four, you can do the exact same thing as verse three if you want. There is an actual extended little cello section solo there, which I'll play here. I'll play it and then I'll go through the actual cello parts. We'll do that here. So we have the same intro. Alright, so something fun for you to do, especially if you're two guitar players here. So, like I said, you can just play the basic chords, but when you get down there to the actual, where that cello line starts, it's going to be open D, then 2-4, then back to 2-4, then first fret of the G. So we have this. Then move up one fret, roll over to the second fret on the D, and fourth fret on the A. So we have this. Start with the open D. And then back to 4-2 on the D string. And then I like to go back into playing those that we did earlier in the other verse. Now we have the same ending lick, except they're going to add something to the very end. So we still have this. That's how we did that before. Instead, now we're going to do this. So it's the same lick, except when you're up here, open A to 4-2 on the D, open D, then 4-2-0 on the A. The A chord with the E in the bass. So it's just kind of fun to play if you have another guitar player, or you can just do it. Just do it like that. All right, now the last chorus. We have a little extend. It goes into the kind of the instrumental section here. Like we said, we're not trying to recreate every little guitar part, just the actual chord progression of the song. So we're going to sound like this, and the chorus is going to have a little extended ending. So that's just the chords, and we have a little cool guitar lick I'll get to in a second. So that's the same chords as before. Now here's where the extension starts. D, D to A. Then we're going to jump down and add that minor chord. The second fret there is the F sharp minor chord. Let that ring, and then back to the D and A, and then go back to the D, D. So we go D, A, then D, E, D. So all together for that last chorus. This cool little guitar lick. All right, then it goes into just total chaos. So it's just going to be a pre-bend at the 6th fret. Now, this is obviously on an electric guitar, so it's a little easier to do that bend on the original recording. But do it. It's the 6th fret, actual 6th fret, or 5th fret above the capo. Hold that bend, pre-bend, and then pick it. Release it. Then open A. Then... So then the 3rd fret above the capo. Then do 2... Hammer on 3, pull back up to 2, over to 4th fret on the G string. And then the rest of the end, the outro. There's just a lot of chaos, some little trills going on the guitar, but it's just really based around the A and just creating just endless amounts of noise. All right, so it's a really cool one just to play on a solo acoustic guitar. Like I said, if you feel more comfortable, you think it sounds better without the capo, you could just simply take the capo off and just play everything down in fret. You won't be much more out of tune than we were to begin with, because you're going to be out of tune either way unless you kind of can fine tune it up into right in between those two pitches. All right, so I hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you again soon for guitar lessons365.com.